Hi everybody. In this video I will show a debugging tool example and their functionalities, which has been shown in the video number 11 called +1 Guide Debugger Tool. This example application does include the logic more or less which is shown in the +1 Guide Fundamental Training, and it is built on a MC24 controller, but as long as we are debugging, which runs on a simulator within Guide, no hardware is needed. The first logic which is used to show the debugger tool is a simple compare function of two input signals. If input A is higher than B, the output is true. In this little example, the output represents an alarm. Input A is coming from the multifunction input pin C2PO5 of an MC24 controller and represents a voltage signal. Input B is a parameter set point value and set as valid set point via a digital trigger input, also from the MC24 controller, while the input pin C1PO6. So we start clicking the run button F9 to run the debugger tool. First, the compile process is starting, including generating the test DLL. As long as we don't have any active breakpoint, the debugger tool runs an endless loop. So for that reason, it is more practicable to start with one of the step buttons, which stops at the first component inside the input page of the template. If the continuous loop is running, we have to interrupt that via the pause button. This gives the user the possibility to step through the code in debugging mode without any breakpoint. After starting the debugger, we have to move to the code inside the guide drawing area, which we want to check. Debug or test. So like in this little example, we move to the application page. For this example, I want to check the logic of the grader component and the correct parameter nominal value. So press Q and select the component grader, which opens the breakpoint window to set the breakpoint and also to make this breakpoint active, which means that the execution will halt or break on that position on any loop. As we can see, after setting a breakpoint on the component grader, the code execution stops in front of the component grader execution. Inside the local variables tab, any input and output is listed of that component where the program stops during debugger mode. The voltage input is 0, the set point value is 2500, and the output alarm is 0. We change the voltage value to 3000, click enter, and use the step button F7 to step after the grader component to see and check the code logic result. We can see the comparison of voltage 3000 is greater than set point 2500, so it is true and the output called alarm does show the value 1. We will change the set point in the following as well to see how this reacts. To do so, we will add these parameters to the watches tab to change the values. We will start adding the previously changed variables as well to the watches tab. Right click in local variables on the listed variables separately and add this to the watch list. On the watches tab, we can see these added variables. In this watch tab, we will right click and choose add. Inside the add watch window, you can select the needed variable from the drop down list. We will add the set point parameter alarm level variable and the trigger signal forced via the MC24 digital input C1PO6 digital in. Now we have all needed variables listed inside the watches list, able to read out and change the values. So let's change the set point. First, change the value of the variable set points or SP parameter alarm level, which will be set immediately after clicking the step or run button. The value of this variable is shown on the net variable name inside the drawing area. A transition component is used inside this example to write the set point on non-volatile memory component. To do so, we set the digital variable to true and click the run button to jump one loop after to the breakpoint in front of the grader component. We can see that The digital signal was used to set the set point to true and used as new comparison input on the greater component. Now we can start changing the voltage value again to see the behavior of the simple application logic. Actually, the green arrow shows the execution point in front of the greater component. If I change the input signal voltage now and click the run or step button, this value is used during the next execution. As you can see, the output is set to 1 as true. Another possibility for testing or debugging is the data breakpoint, the checkmark column at the right of the watches tab. If the value of this watched variable changes, the loop execution stops via a data breakpoint at the component position. So I will checkmark the variable CP alarm, so checkpoint alarm, and change the input value of voltage so that the watched variable checkpoint alarm changes and the loop execution stops. The blue down arrow shows the execution stop via a data breakpoint, and in difference to a normal breakpoint, which stops before a component execution, a data breakpoint stops execution when the component is on execution stack. As you can see, and it stops because the checkpoint alarm variable changes from 0 to 1. And this use case can be used to avoid stopping on that component in any loop and just stop if a value change happened. Let's take a short look to the call stack tab. In this tab, the name of the component, the path, and the position is listed where the code execution currently stopped. Double click on that type will display the component in the middle of the guide drawing area window. In the guide setup options, you can set under debugger tool the setting full C call stack. If this setting is checkmarked, a column called C code is shown in the call stack tab as well. You can double click on that line to open the .c file from the C compiler to give you the possibility to debug in C code as well. You have also the possibility to add active breakpoints inside the .c file, and you can follow the logic, but the debugger will not open the .c file and jump to that breakpoint automatically. After the call stack tab, we will jump into the breakpoints tab where all currently created breakpoints are listed. You can set any listed breakpoint as active and delete them, of course. In the column condition, you have the possibility to set conditional breakpoints that trigger when conditions that you have defined become true. When you move your mouse over the condition column, all the available C language Boolean expressions will be shown. I will set a condition which breaks when the voltage signal is below 500. Click run or step and change the voltage value to check the condition. Once the voltage value is below the condition 500, the execution breaks. Another useful tab for debugging is a loop input where you can assign values for input values according to loop index. After first open the loop input tab, the field is empty. There you have the possibility to add lines which refers to the loop index and select columns to add loop input signals. I will add the currently used variables to check the simple logic of this little example. So I will add the signal's voltage from the input pin C2PO5, the set point parameter, and the digital trigger signal C1PO6. After selecting the loop input signal or signals, I will add lines to the tab. Now I'm able to set the values of any loop input signal for any available loop index. I will start to a kind of initializing or initialization of the input signals to have a start condition. Then start triggering the set point to a new value. And after that, set the voltage to a value just below and just a little above the set point. After adding all these loop input signals, you can run or step through the code using these input signals. You can also export these settings to a CSV file and, of course, also import a CSV file. For the import feature, you can add these CSV file signal in front or at the end of the existing loop input signals. You can replace or merge with the existing debug input, and I use the new other version guide 12.0, and from that version and following, we have also the possibility to map the imported CSV file signals with the available loop input signal names, which makes it much more easier to share debugger signal files on different hardware platforms and application as well. Instead of adding loop input signals manually, you can also add debug inputs from available test cases. Test cases are used inside the +1 guide test tool to perform tests on guide code. To do so, the test tool creates page level test cases with a test case definition table with columns for the values that you want to input when you execute the test case and values that expect be output as a result of the test execution. The test tool is a feature of the +1 guide add-on. While the project manager, you are able to add or use these test cases as debug input. Right-click the test case and choose use test case as debug input. While the context menu, you have the same possibilities like I already described for importing loop input signals from CSV file, including mapping the signal names between test case and loop input. The last debugger tab, which is available in debugger mode up to guide 11.1, is the loop output tab. This one is used to record or display the output signals of program loops. As all tabs, this will be empty from the very first beginning, but keep in mind that your debugging settings like adding variables, setting values, and so on will be stored and are available on future debugging sessions as well. So via right-click, you can select columns to add available loop output signals or available watches to the loop output signal list. The list of available loop output signals depends on the selected hardware. The available watches list all available variables which has been added to the watches tab. This gives the possibility to record any input and variable inside the application as well as loop output signal. Edit output signals needs to be enabled. So enable means that this output signal will be used to record values. Disable means this column and the output signal is grayed out and will not display any value. So now we are able to record the output signal. As we are forcing the input signal, we can start the run button in continuous loop and check the result. The input and output values are displayed, and it shows also the result value of the output alarm depending on the input signal values. Like the loop input, the loop output can be exported to a CSV file as well. In this video, using the pre-version of guide 12.0, you also can see the additional tab initial values, which contain a grid and shows for every available input signal the name, type, and the default initial value. By default, all values will be zero, but also synchronized with any input values that are specified on the first line of the loop inputs tab. Another example is the dual path application, which is also mentioned and shown during the +1 guide fundamental training. On the top, there is the graphical guide code for calculate the right and left pump. and the same logic has been transferred into a PLC PoU written in IEC 61139-3 language and structured text. The PoU has been implemented via the call component inside the guide code. We will start create a breakpoint on the call component and add variables to the watches tab so that we are able to trigger some inputs and validate the calculated output variables. I will add the propel variable, which is connected to a hardware input C2PO5, and the steer variable connected to the hardware input C2PO7. After adding these variables, we can compare both logic outputs directly via the net variable values, which should be the same. We know that the already tested graphical guide code is correct, so if there are some variation, they must be located inside the PoU code. So like it is in this case, where we can locate a wrong output value produced from the PoU. To check this in detail, you are able to open the PLC editor during debugging mode and add the breakpoint inside the text-based code. The breakpoint inside the PoU will break the execution like any other breakpoint inside the graphical guide code is doing. The PLC editor will be opened automatically and shows you the breakpoint and the current values on the top. In this little example, a wrong data type has been used in combination with multiplying values which are outside the scope of its ability to handle. The solution in this case is to use correct data type, which can handle the calculated values which are shown in this code change. Inside or via the structured text PoU, you can use the same features, comments, and windows of the debugger like you used before. The PLC editor window will stay in front, and you can switch to all other debugger window as well. We hope that you found this tutorial useful. Remember that +1 community help is available on the +1 user forum. Check out other videos on our YouTube channel or contact the +1 help desk. Thank you for your attention.